Piers Morgan has been at the forefront of exposing the lies and scandals of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle since the couple got married. And with the release of Omid Scobie's new book Endgame, Piers Morgan is back to dispel rumours and hold the fame-hungry Sussexes to account. Piers Morgan broke the internet when he revealed the names of the alleged royal racists who inquired about the skin colour of Meghan and Harry's firstborn son Archie, named by Omid Scobie in the Dutch translation of his book Endgame.
The royals who are named in this book are King Charles and Catherine, Princess of Wales.
The host justified his revelations, saying people deserved to know what had already been public knowledge in the Netherlands.
Well, last night I decided this was all ridiculous, and it was time to name the two royals implicated in those racism claims. They are, as I said last night, King Charles, Prince Charles as he was then, and Catherine, Princess of Wales. I did that for several reasons. First, the speculation was once again raging out of control, as it has for 2.5 years. Second, it made no sense that Dutch journalists and Dutch people who bought copies before the publisher withdrew them would know these names, members of our royal family, when the British people were prevented from knowing them. Thirdly, once you know the names, it becomes blindingly obvious to anyone with even half a brain that these allegations are ridiculous. Whatever your view of the monarchy, I don't think any serious person really believes that anything they've seen or heard from King Charles or the Princess of Wales suggests they have even the tiniest racist bone in their bodies or would judge anybody according to the shade of their skin.
Piers Morgan slammed Prince Harry and Meghan Markle for failing to mention the racism row in their Netflix series or in Harry's book Spare, which he released at the start of the year, but instead waited for the release of Omid Scobie's book to reignite the scandal.
And once again, it's worth remembering what Prince Harry eventually said about these accusations when he was promoting his book. And before we play the clip, just to remind you, after launching this racist bombshell 2.5 years ago, it never got mentioned again. Not in the 6-part Netflix series, which mentioned everything else in their lives. Not in the 12-part podcast for Spotify that Meghan Markle did, never mentioned. And it never got mentioned in Harry's over 400-page book. 150,000 words of stuff about his entire life, but not a mention of the supposed racism by members of his own family, which he had launched as a missile against that family on Oprah Winfrey. So this is what he said to Tom Bradby at ITN at the start of this year when promoting the book where he didn't mention it.
In the Oprah interview, you accuse members of your family of racism. You don't even...
The British press said that.
Right.
Did Meghan ever mention that they were racist?
She said there were troubling comments about
His skin colour.
Right. Wouldn't you describe that as essentially racist?
I wouldn't, not having lived within that family.
God, he's such a dimwit, isn't he? He's just dim as ditch water. He literally thinks we're going to watch the clips back from Oprah and not think that she was saying that the royal family had been racist. How dumb does he think we are? So Harry performs this dramatic U-turn. Oh, we never meant to suggest they were racist. It was the terrible British press. They were the ones who said it was racism. We just meant unconscious bias. You know what that's become a euphemism for? We actually haven't got any evidence of someone being racist. We just think it's kind of unconscious, on the sly, right? It's kind of there, but we can't prove it. It's like, we think they might be. Yeah, not good enough. Not when it comes to members of the royal family. His reputations are on a global stage.
Piers Morgan also went on to question the integrity of Omid Scobie, referencing times the author lied about Piers Morgan himself.
So why should I stand back and let a proven liar like Omid Scobie, a man who claims in this book as a fact that I have regular phone chats with Queen Camilla? Regular. Do you know how many times I've spoken to Queen Camilla on the phone in my entire 58-year life? Zero. Not once. It's not just not regular, it's never happened. We've never had a phone chat. So he's a liar. And he lied again about when apparently I called Meghan Markle Princess Pinocchio on that fateful last day of Good Morning Britain. Apparently Camilla immediately contacted me to thank me on behalf of the firm. No, she didn't. Another lie. Complete lie. So Scobie prepared to lie about me, about these little things, which don't really amount to a row of beans. Why should we believe anything else he has to say? All he's doing is dragging the whole royal family through the mud all over again, reigniting these racism charges because he wants to sell books and make money.
Princess Diana's former butler backed up Piers Morgan's claims, saying there are no racists in the royal family.
Again, Paul, my problem with Omid Scobie is, yes. I think he's just a scammer. I think he goes over all the stuff that's already out there and he puts two and two together and often gets five, six, seven, eight. I don't think he'd know the truth if it slapped him around his Botox chops.
No, well, Dickie and I both have lived with the royal family for many, many years. We know all the major players. We know that there are no racists within the royal family. How could our late queen be racist when she was head of the Commonwealth? I mean, it's just ridiculous, this conversation, because I bet this never happened. They must have dreamt it up one night. I mean, when they pressed that button on the Oprah Winfrey show, the racist button, they never pressed reset. And our dear late queen went to her grave worrying, thinking there was some upset in the House of Windsor. Now, Harry should be ashamed of that for upsetting his grandmother, because all of this is just nonsense. And there are no racists in the royal family. Dickie, you know that.
Piers Morgan unsurprisingly agrees with the motion to strip Prince Harry and Meghan Markle of their royal titles.
I think it's time we brought the Sussex circus to a formal end. Conservative MP Bob Seeley is now introducing a bill in Parliament to strip them formally of their titles. The Duke and Duchess can be Mr. and Mrs. like the rest of us, he said. Someone doesn't want to be a royal, that's a decision we respect. They shouldn't keep the titles and privileges if they trash an institution that plays an important part in our nation's life. I think he's right. And as he also says, the baseless racism claims that have now embroiled the King and Princess of Wales, well, they should be the final straw, shouldn't they?
He says the Sussex brand will become worthless without the royal titles.
And don't give the grifters any more grist to the mill.
But the grifters make most of their money because they have royal titles.
Of course they do.
The American business model collapses if they're just plain Harry and Meghan. Not immediately, but it would over time. If they can't slap all over all their correspondence that they're the Duke and Duchess, it disappears.
Possibly, that remains to be seen.
However, not everyone is in agreement. With historian Sir Anthony Seldon saying stripping Meghan and Harry of their titles just makes them victims and gives them more publicity.
Purely kind of constitutionally, historically, is it even possible to wrestle the titles away from them?
Well, I'm sure it is, Piers. The question is it all worth it? And is it going to be what they want because it just makes them more out to be victims of these hateful, exploitative people in Buckingham Palace? Wouldn't it just be better just to let them be forgotten and not to react? Because by reacting, by doing this, the Bob Seeley idea, I think it just makes them into victims, gives them even more publicity. There they are over all the world's headlines again as people, there must be some truth surely in what they're both saying. And I think that is not the right way to handle it. They're both clearly two very, very damaged people. They need help. I don't think they need stripping their royal titles.
Piers Morgan clashed with a guest on his show who maintained the royal family does have an issue with racism.
I appreciate that you find it personally offensive, Piers, but shall I tell you what I find concerning? That in this discussion about racism, we know that the institution has issues. We know that in 2021, we were supposed to see the appointment of a diversity czar, and I'm still waiting for that appointment.
What is a diversity czar?
Well, we can discuss that another day.
Let me finish.
Well, Piers, this is important. This is important.
The royal family employ a lot more non-white people.
You don't want to hear it, Piers.
It's a fact that they employ a lot more non-white people than they used to. Right? It's also a fact they remain exclusively white, other than the Meghan Markle part of it, because they're all a white family.
Piers, don't shut me down on this point, because this is important for
us to discuss. Distracting away from the alleged racism in this story. Trevor Phillips, who ran the
do
big...
Do you see what's happening here?
No, I'm asking you a question about this particular topic.
I haven't finished answering your first
question. You're talking about other things.
I'm not talking about other things. I'm talking about exactly what you're referencing, the allegation of racism, and why it's important for for society as a whole, for us to see that the institution is dealing with this. And I'm saying to you, where is the diversity czar?
What racism? Where is the diversity czar
that we were told was going to be appointed in 2021? We were told that this was such an important thing and that it was going to happen.
Where's the racism,
because
Paula?
Of the concerns.
Paula.
Because
where is the
of
racism?
The concerns that Meghan had. Yeah, that's what was
what
reported.
What concerns?
Secondly,
she didn't even hear
also,
it.
We've also
she
had
didn't even
reports.
Hear it. And by the way, she thought it happened when she was pregnant. Harry said it happened before they got engaged.
Shouting
Which
me
one
down
is
not going
no,
to change the
nonsense.
Fact that I'm concerned.